So in this video, we're going to be talking about Time Machine and the importance of backups. Hey everyone, my name is Emilio and this video is brought to you by Moonlock, where we do cybersecurity technology for humans. Before we do get into the video, remember as always to click on that subscription button, click on the bell so you don't miss out on any of our video releases. Now, have you ever been in a situation? I know I have been in a situation. I've spoken to lots of people who've been in situations where they have lost data and they're not able to get that data back. They've accidentally deleted a file. A file has just been lost and they can't get it back. And why can't they get it back? Because there's been no backups. This is why it's very, very important to ensure that you are properly backing up your Mac. You need to make sure that all of your files, all of your precious data, your photos, your videos, your documents, your business work is backed up and saved somewhere securely. So in the event that you do lose some data, you can get it back. And you know what? A lot of people don't think about backups until it's too late. The same way that you want to get car insurance, house insurance, medical insurance. Why do you get these things? Well, just in case something should go wrong. And when something does go wrong, you are glad that you have it. This is why it's very, very important to make sure that you've got a proper backup plan. In the event that you have something like malware or ransomware getting onto your files, corrupting your files, having a good backup strategy secures your Mac as well, because then you can recover files back from an earlier version before they were potentially encrypted or affected by a virus or malware. Now, the Mac has a great built-in backup solution called Time Machine, built into every single Mac, regardless of what version of macOS you are running. It's been around for a very, very long time, and it's the easiest way to back up your Mac. The easiest way to get Time Machine up and running is get yourself a big enough external USB hard drive. You want to make sure that you have a USB hard drive that is bigger, maybe 2 to 3 times larger than the capacity of your Mac. Let's say your Mac has 1 terabyte hard drive built in, you may wanna look at buying yourself a 2 or a 3 terabyte external drive, because Time Machine is gonna be running perhaps daily, weekly, whatever the schedule is, and you wanna make sure that you've got multiple versions of all of the files that are being backed up. If you don't have enough capacity on your USB hard drive, you're gonna run out of space a lot quicker. So the bigger the external hard drive will be, the more backup data you'll be able to keep, and for longer. You can also back up your data to an external NAS. A NAS is what's called a network attached storage. Essentially, it's a server that is dedicated for storing of data. And a lot of people at homes, in businesses, use these NAS devices. You can also set that up so that it can act as your NAS location and where your backups actually live. Now, here's the last thing that I will talk about before we do get into the demo. Make sure that wherever your backups are going, that those backups are going off site. So for example, if you're at home and you are backing up all of your data from your Mac, from your laptop, from your desktop Mac, and you're backing it up to a USB hard drive, what if you have an issue at home? What if your home gets damaged and you lose the data that's on your Mac? You'll also lose your USB hard drive, or your backups are keeping, and then you've lost both. So it's good practice sometimes to back up your data to a location and then get that USB hard drive somewhere else. Give it to a friend, give it to a family member, keep it in their location, and then bring it back whenever you need to do additional backups, all right? Having said that, we're now gonna jump onto our Mac. I'm running the latest version of macOS, and we're gonna show you how to set up macOS Time Machine. The first thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna grab myself my hard drive, okay? Got a little USB there on the side, and I'm gonna plug that into the side of my Mac. This is gonna plug into my USB-C. You can plug into your old sort of USB as well. This particular drive, I think, is 3 terabytes big, so it's gonna be more than capable to back up my Mac. So let's go and plug it in. So the hard drive should now show up here on your Mac. It is over here, stuff. This is my hard drive. There's nothing in it at the moment. Now, if you need to go and get the hard drive ready, you may actually want to go and format it. And that's something that I probably would recommend as the first point of contact. If it doesn't show up, go into applications, you can go down to the utility section and go into disk utility over here and format it. You can also look for this in the spotlight. Sometimes disks are formatted in a format that maybe the Mac can't see. So just go and format it first so that it shows up. Once it shows up, we're good to go from there. And we now need to go and open up the system settings section on your Mac. And to do this, you go into the top left-hand corner and select system settings. Inside of your system settings, we're gonna select general, and we're gonna go down to the section here called time machine. You'll see there's already a backup over here that's already been done previously, but let's actually read what this says. So time machine backs up your computer and keeps local snapshots and hour backups for the past 24 hours. Daily backups for the past month and weekly backups for all previous months. The oldest backups and any local snapshots are deleted as space is needed. And that is the key right there, as space is needed. Essentially how big your hard drive is the amount of capacity and the data that will be kept on that hard drive. The bigger the drive, the more data you can keep on it. Now, the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna click on the options section to have a look at what's available to us right over here. Now, within options, it's gonna show you a few different options here under backup frequency, automatically every hour, every day, and every week. Do you want the backups to automatically just kick off, where your Mac will do a little bit of a scan of your computer every hour, and if there are any files that are new, any files that have changed, that have been edited, it'll back those up and those alone. Every day, we'll do the same thing daily, weekly, or manually. Manually meaning, well, you only can kick off a backup when you tell it to backup. I generally recommend leaving it as automatically every hour. That way, you don't have to worry about it. As long as your hard drive is plugged in, it'll do a scan every hour and back it up. Then you've got backup on battery power. I've got myself a MacBook Pro, so when it's plugged in, it'll do a backup when it has a hard drive plugged into it, but it's also when it's on battery, I'm gonna have it to do a backup as well. You have the option to turn this on and off, because if you're gonna be on battery, of course, your battery's gonna drain a little bit faster if it is doing a backup, so just be aware of that. Exclude from backups. Well, there are some folders, some files that I may not wanna include in my backup for whatever purposes. I've got some ISO files, some very, very big ISO files of operating systems that I use for, you know, building of servers. And then I've got a whole bunch of big raw content for videos that I don't need to include in my backup. So I've chosen to not include those in here. But if you want to back up everything, then you leave this area blank. But it's nice to know that you have this option. Done. So let's now click on the plus and find our hard drive. All right, there it is. There is our stuff hard drive. It's got 255 gig free, which is going to be enough for this demo. But of course, the bigger your hard drive, the better. Once it's found it in here, you click on setup disk. Now, if yours has not been found, it could be because it's not been formatted. It's not been discovered by your Mac. So make sure you go and format it first. Once you're happy with that, select setup disk. Okay, now it's going to ask me to encrypt or not. Essentially, you want to encrypt your data. You want to make sure that it's scrambled, gives it extra bit of security. So I'm going to recommend that you do have that turned on, but if you turn it off, then you don't get any password options. So we're going to turn that on, and we're now going to enter in a password. Throw in a hint. This is a hint. And then the disk usage limit, none or custom. Custom means, well, how big do I want my actual backup job to be in total? So I may actually make it a little bit smaller. I only want it to be 120 gig big. That is the capacity that I want to use. Otherwise, none. We'll use the entire capacity that is available to it on the hard drive. If you're happy with that, click on done. Now it's preparing the stuff hard drive, and now the backup job is starting. You'll see that it's waiting to backup, and the next backup job will now kick off in a few seconds. You'll notice it lets you know how much percentage it's completed, how many minutes are remaining, and how much gigabytes have been copied over. Now this will take a little bit of time depending on how much data you've got, and then we'll check back once it's done. So backup is now done. Here it is. Here's the stuff hard drive. This is how much gig I've got available. Wasn't very big, and now it's automatically gonna do another backup in the next hour. All right, so that is now ready to go. If you wanna remove it, you can just click on this little minus and it'll sort of give you a warning. Are you sure you wanna remove this and forget the destination? Now you can sort of leave the thing and it's gonna be ready to go, and it'll just do a good job. Let's actually go and show you how it works, right? So here I am in my Finder. I've got some files in here called documents, and here are some things that I've got, right? I've got a couple of folders. Now to open up the time machine, we go and open up our Finder applications. We're gonna scroll down to Time Machine over here. Now you may also have a little icon on the very top right-hand corner of your Mac. If you have that, you can open that one as well. But now we double click on this, and now we get this really, really cool animation. Now what I can do is now this is set up, you can see that the date says today. Now because this is my first backup, I'm not gonna be able to go further back, but essentially what you can now do is you can now go back in time. And you notice that the time changes slightly. So I can go all the way back to a backup, for example, that happened today at 9:23 a.m. And this is what my Mac would have looked like. You'll notice that the movies here is grayed out because I'm excluding that one. But now I can literally go through my Mac and restore things from that point in time. So let's just show you very quickly how we do this. Cancel. Here is my Finder. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go into Documents, into Parallels, and I'm just gonna go and delete these two files right over here. Let's just delete them. They're now gone, okay? Oh no, I've accidentally deleted my files and I need to go do a recovery. Let's go ahead and open up our Time Machine. So under my Documents, you'll notice that Parallels is empty. It does not exist. But if I go back in time, there are the files that I've just deleted. I can now select them and click on Restore. Those files have now been restored from my backup. So now you can fully rest assured that all of your files are backed up. As long as you're doing it regularly, good to go. As I said before, I recommend taking that hard drive that you're using, taking it off site, bringing it back when you need to. Otherwise, you can always have a backup running consistently and then recover files as they're deleted. So with Time Machine all set up, remember that your backups are very, very important. So make sure that you have a good backup plan in place to get that backup location, whether if it's going to be from a NAS or from a USB hard drive, get it sent offsite so that way your data is protected outside of where your main data is living. That's it for this video. Thank you so much for tuning in. Hopefully you found it helpful. If you did, give us a thumbs up by giving us a like on this video. Let us know down below in the comments what you thought. And as always, click on that subscription button on the bell, and we'll see you on the next video.